What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of CP Customs Budget Build. In today's episode, we are going to take a closer look on the front steering, why it's so hard to turn it from left to right. Something is wrong there. We're going to reassemble the rear sets, check the macro rims and tires, and some of the cool stuff as well. So stay tuned. So guys, game plan for today is to take care about the steering because something isn't right here. Something is wrong, and let me show you what I mean. So guys, basically here inside is the front end mounted, and you turn it with your handlebar to the left and right, depends on which direction you want to go. But the force you need to turn it from left to right is just incredible. This is I can't describe it. Is this, you may can see it a bit and hear it maybe. It's not smooth. It's not smooth at all. It is hard, it's stuck from the way to left and right, and I think the bearings inside are toast, completely not functionable anymore. They're dry, they're not good, nothing is smooth here, so I have to check for the bearings and replace it. I'm gonna make this smooth again. So, enough talking, let's go.
Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
And as expected, as you can see, this is the bearing, and you see all this dirt, all this dust inside, so that's the problem. So it's a bit easier right now, because everything seems like to be dry as well for the brake caliper, for the brake lines, and it's also super dry. So let's check how the other one looks. So here we go, both bearings visible right now, and both are just not good anymore. They're completely stuck. I can't spin it anymore. Should be able to spin, but it is so sticky inside, I can't turn nothing. It is just like glued together. Very, very bad for your steering, and very, very bad for everything else what is supposed to be supported by a bearing. Check for them if they are not good anymore, replace it. The task is to get this one off and replace it with some nice and shiny ones.
It sound right, boys.
That was not easy, but I made it with a little bit help of fire. it was possible to get this basic bearing off. Here it was very sticky at the bottom, a lot of force to get it off, but take your time, use heat, and then yeah, you will succeed. So
just to compare a new one with the old one. So the old one, I can't basically do nothing. It's just like glued together all parts. It's just very sticky toast. And this is the new one. And as you can see, you how easy you can spin it. So this is how it should, yeah, how it should be also when it's inside the bike.
So the next step is to get out the housing of the bearing. So this is the new housing. So this must go here inside, but therefore we have to remove the old one because as you can see it is also dirty and rusty and sticky. So we cannot use the old one, we have to use a new one. And yeah, let's try to get this one out. And the bottom one. It's gonna be so much fun.
Sound right, boy.
It is time to get the bearing back on the steering stuff. So it's a bit tricky because it's very tight. So one trick is I put that in the freezer. So if it gets cold, it will shrink and your bearing should be warm. So I'm gonna try to put this on. Yeah, let's check this out. So. So ladies and gentlemen, the new bearings are inside and they are great. If you remember the situation before we changed the bearings, you know, it was really hard to turn from left to right, and now look at this. Whoops. So that's good. As you can see here, look at this. It's not adjusted yet, but I want to show you how easy this is now. This is how it's supposed to be. So if you have a very hard steering, check for your bearings. They're probably not the best anymore. Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, the steering is good again. As you can see, this is now turning nice and smooth. So that's very good, that's done. So the other question is what to do with the front end in general, because I know what I'm gonna do with the tires and the rims. So glossy black rims, new tires, paint the discs into glossy black too, not the complete disc, just the center of disc. And now it's just the question, I want to create this cool cafe racer look. So in that case, we have to get a bit more deeper in the front section. So there are many opportunities how to do this. There are complete new front end kits which are awesome and great and good looking and fantastic, but way over my budget. It's a budget project. It is a budget channel, so I doubt I'm gonna invest into a complete new kit. But what is possible to make the original front end a bit deeper. There are also different opportunities how to do this. And before I tell you what I'm gonna do, I have to think about it, because I'm not an expert about front end, and especially not what is happening inside there. So I have to learn a bit more about that topic, and then I'm gonna tell you in the next episodes what I'm gonna do. But we're gonna definitely work with the original front end and make it cooler, definitely cooler, different color, some additional stuff, deeper, more badass. So yeah, that was an update, and yeah, let's continue with the other stuff. So, ladies and gentlemen, what a pain, but it is, yeah, fulfilled. I have separated the tires from the rims, pain in, you know, but yeah, success. You don't have to do this by yourself. There are tire companies with tire service machines which are doing this for a very small amount of price, like 10-20 bucks, so you can save a lot of time and nerves. But you can also separate them by yourself with a little bit of effort. Never mind. So I also remove the bearings inside the front wheel. There are two of them. I did not the best job doing this because I destroyed both of them. Never mind, because I already wanted to use new ones, so I have to order these. So it doesn't matter if they're toast or not, the old ones. So I'm gonna bring these these rims. I'm gonna bring these rims the next days to a company, to a powder coating company, which is gonna powder coat them into glossy black. Yeah, because I can't do it. There are powder coating machines you can buy. That's not the problem. It is the heating. I don't have a big oven to heat them up properly, so I can't do this. So that will be the job of another company. So let me show you the parts I removed. The brake discs. We're gonna paint the brake discs. This area here, so all the surface which is not involved into the brake pad, into glossy black too. Have to clean this. I'm gonna throw all these parts we need, like the screws and the things inside the front wheel, into our cool ultrasonic cleaner. It is already heating up, so I'm gonna throw everything inside there, and guys, that was it. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked what you see, please consider subscribing. For the next episodes, a lot of work to do, a lot of fun left. So make sure you're not gonna miss this. Stay tuned and goodbye. Peace.